So the topic of the day is differentiated learning. Roadmap, is it visible, sir? Sir, excuse me.
Yeah, it's fine, it's fine. It's fine, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, please go ahead.
Yes. The roadmap of the program, differentiated learning, strategies to differentiate instruction, different activities for differentiated learning. So during this pandemic period, we are not able to travel anywhere. So go ahead. Suppose after 6 months, we are going to travel somewhere in the world. Which area you will prefer? London Bridge is falling down, waiting for you. Paris, you want to be there close to motherland, Taj Mahal, Switzerland. And I am welcoming you here to UAE, the tallest building, Burj Khalifa. Or you want to be there at home and enjoy the home feeling. What do you want? Just give me some, words through the chat box. It's quite appreciable. Yes. May I get some answers? I'm not able to see you, okay? Sir?
They are putting in the chat box. Those who want to answer can unmute themselves.
Yes.
Considering the situation, I think everybody wants to be in the homeland. Otherwise,
Switzerland seems to be good out of the options.
So I welcome you to UAE, okay? this is just to connect you to that topic, okay? So Carol Ann Tomlinson is known as the guru of differentiation. So differentiation really means trying to make sure that teaching and learning work for the full range of students, which really should be our goal as teachers. So we have different categories of students in our classroom. Students are have variety of interests, prior educational experience. Their motivation level will be different. Their readiness for learning will be different. Personal experience, background will be different. So we have to accommodate all these students in our classroom. So WARC learning style. WARC means visual, auditory, read and write, kinesthetic. So today let me introduce two learners to you. You are familiar with these two learners, Patkar Kumar and Karkar Kumari. I have taken this from the experiential learning document of CBSE. So Patkar Kumar, who is Patkar Kumar? Patkar Kumar is saying that read, write and learn. Padoge, likhoge, benoge, nawab. And Karkar Kumari is a kinesthetic learner. Khel, khel mein hum seekhte hai jana. So you can see auditory learner. I have given another name for her, Sundar Kumari. And you could see visual learner, Drishya Kumari. And at last, we have to incorporate all these students and to give a holistic approach to education. And that I have given. We should bring the students as Samagra Kumari or Samagra Kumar. That's our aim as teachers. So how to differentiate? Teachers can differentiate through content, process, and product. Learning environment is common for teachers and students. So what about students? Their readiness for learning, their interest, and their learning profile. So what is students' learning profile? A student's learning profile is the complete picture of his or her learning preferences, strengths, and challenges. And is shaped by the categories of learning style, intelligence, preference, and culture and gender. Next is differentiated learning by teachers through content. Content, knowledge and skills that students need to learn based on the curriculum. Process, varying learning activities or strategies. Product, assessments, tired assignments, all these comes under product. So differentiating through content. Content comprises of the knowledge, concepts, and skills that students need to learn based on the curriculum. So what the teacher plans to teach, it will come under content. And what the students need to learn, it will come under content. And next is process, differentiating through process. How will the students access the information? Activities in which the students engage in order to make sense of or master the content. And next, differentiating through product. How the students will demonstrate what he or she has learned. Pre-assessment and formative assessment consistently give a clear picture of the learners, who is confused, who is behind, and who is ahead. Next, extended learning. So flexible classroom. For differentiated learning, we need flexible grouping. How to group a classroom? We can give some time whole class instruction, but the instruction is not complete with whole class instruction. Homogeneous group can be created. Group according to same skill level can be created. Heterogeneous groups can be created. And randomized group work we can give. And sometime we can give for even individual learning. So how do we differentiate through different activities? So tic-tac-toe board, think-tac-toe board, menu planner, PMI, Venn diagram, raft activities, story map, Fryer model, concept maps. These are some of the activities through which we can inculcate, differentiate learning, or we can establish differentiate learning in our classroom. First, I have taken tic-tac-toe board or think-tac-toe board. This one I have presented in a form of multiple intelligence, verbal and linguistic, write instructions, keep a journal, create a poem, a logical or mathematical, create patterns, design a game like that, visual, create a poster, a comic strip, draw a map, interpersonal, role play, interview, tell stories, then musical and rhythmic, create raps, music, create rhymes, the naturalist learners, collect and categorize or discover or experiment, interpersonal, keep a journal, a personal journal. So this one I have created considering multiple intelligence. So when we give the activity, how do we give the activity? So we have to give in a diagonal form. White, green, white. So that green color is a free choice for the students. That is the core content we are going to teach in the class. I'll give you an example afterwards. So white, green, white, yellow, green, yellow, blue, green, blue. This way we have to give the activity in think-tac-toe board. So I have taken an example for an activity. So I have taken winter season here. So for mathematical students, use a Venn diagram, compare and contrast winter with another season. Logical thinking learners, we can give that. And for naturalist learners, we can give make a master species list of winter birds or winter animals. So visual and kinesthetic visual learners, we can give create winter patterns and write about it. That will come under art integrated category also. Create a poster celebrating winter season. Then musical and rhythmic group, create a song about winter season using the tune, visual, verbal and linguistic, write a short poem on winter season. Then intrapersonal, write a letter to your friend about winter fashion. Then interpersonal, think about a winter camp and prepare the plan. For body and kinesthetic, construct a vocabulary wall of 15 to 20 words associated with winter season. So this way you can present a think-tac-toe board in the classroom. It will accommodate all range of learners and it is based on multiple intelligence. Next activity, menu planner. Menu, when we think about menu, we are thinking about different types of dishes. So here main dishes, menu planner can be created this way. So main dishes, everybody should do. There is no option for the students. All the students should complete. We can give two, three activities there. Then side dishes, there they can select four activities. If the teacher is giving, students can select one or two or three. Then those who finishes this main dishes and side dishes, that means main activity and the side, the other activity, they will be served with desserts. So last we used to serve desserts, right? So they will be served with this desserts activity. There you can give critical thinking questions, creative thinking questions in a little very interesting way, like they should feel that it is a dessert for them. So that way you can give. Here, a menu planner, you can serve the students a North Indian dishes or a South Indian thali. It's a wide range of colors and different kinds of dishes. This is a very good activity which can be done in this classroom. So menu activity, this is another way to give menu activities for the students. And the next one, Fryer model. So here it is to identify and define unfamiliar concepts and vocabulary. Central, we are giving a keyword. I have given here democracy. It's an example of Fryer model. I have given the keyword democracy. Then one side they have to write the definition, and the other side characteristics of democracy, and next examples of democracy, India and other countries they can write. The non-examples they can write, UAE, Kuwait and all they can write. So here usually we give, write the definition of democracy, then write the characteristics of democracy, write to examples, write to non-examples. To avoid all this, we can give this in a format of Fryer model. So students will be more interested to do such activities. So I have given another example for Fryer model. This is a poem from grade 11, childhood. So one side I gave definition and a thought on childhood, then characteristics of childhood and words associated with other stages of life, childhood photo, words associated with students' childhood. Maybe they will write paperboard or crayons or toys, their choice. So this is called Fryer model activity. And next, storytelling. Stories are always powerful means of language teaching, develop listening, speaking, and the ability to read and write easily and completely. Storytelling is an effective pedagogy, and you could see that in NEP or experiential learning document, everywhere you could see this storytelling, because stories associated with images and link, it will be helpful for the students to connect things or information. And I have created another activity for storytelling. Here I have taken germination. So setting of the story will be sowing. Characters, seeds, water, sunlight. So beginning of the story, absorption of water by the dry seed, then middle of the story, effect of sunlight on seed germination, and end, the cell grow in size and begin divisions to form the seedling. So this is a story map. The teacher can create a story based on this. Instead of telling the students what is germination, if it is told in a story, it will be more appealing for the students. They will remember it fast and they can organize it afterwards in an organized way. And the next one is Venn diagram. Venn diagrams are popular version of compare and contrast graphic organizers. So these include two or more circles intersecting, where the circle intersect to overlap, students write or type in the similarities, and where the circle do not intersect, the students write differences. So I took a very simple example here. Different apple and pumpkin I took here. So red, small, light. Pumpkin, orange, big, heavy, and same hard seeds for both. This is a very simple, and this is useful for maths, divisible by, and such teaching, such concept can be taught easily through this Venn diagram. And next is raft activity. Raft means raft, role of the writer, audience, format, topic. It includes writing from different viewpoints. So it teaches students to think creatively about writing by responding to the following prompts. So role of the writer. Who are you as a writer? Audience. To whom are you writing? Format. What form will the writing take? Topic. What's the subject or point of this piece? So I have given again activities here taken from different subjects. Bird. So birds are complaining to Wright brothers. New invention disrupts their sky's movement in the sky. And Great Wall of China. It's a diary entry. Invaders I have seen and stopped. So history they will learn. Invaders of Great Wall of China. So instead of simply teaching the information, if they write it as a diary entry, Great Wall of China is writing its emotions along with the information. So it will be more appealing for the students. Next, rainforest. Audience, humans. It's a complaint. Deforestation. The next, a red blood cell. Audience, lungs. Thank you, not. Journey through circulatory system. So the teacher is teaching circulatory system here through a thank you knot from a red blood cell. So the role of red blood cell is described here. The students will write a thank you knot. So they will remember that more clearly afterwards. Next, zero. Zero, audience whole numbers. It can be a campaign, election campaign speech or a story of zero. So importance of the story of importance of the number zero, election campaign students will speak about that, and story of zero can be spoken in the classroom. So different way can be given. Then water drop to other water drops. It's a travel guide form. So journey through water cycle. So we are teaching evaporation, condensation, precipitation, but we are teaching it as a travel guide. That is water drop to other water drops. Next is cubing as an instructional tool. Cubing is an instructional strategy that asks students to consider a concept from a variety of different perspectives. So always six-sided figures will be there for this activity. So here to establish one word. Define that word, then use in a sentence, plural of that word, singular of that word, synonym, antonym. So the complete, the word, the student is learning the completeness of that word, or the student is learning about that word in a full way. Another activity which I have taken for this cube creator, illustrate the setting of the poem. Draw your picture for the title that is connected to the poem, but not the title of the poem. So draw a picture which is connected to the title of the poem, but not the title of the poem. Then figurative language, list out all the poetic devices in the poem. Then speaker, describe the speaker of the poem. Lines, create four lines of your own based on the theme of the poem. Then rhyme, figure out the rhyme scheme of the poem, then here theme, describe the theme of the poem in a paragraph. So the poem is taught in the class with an activity that is cube creator, but the students will think in different perspective. Next is bio cube planner. This is nothing to relate it with biology. It is related to introduce a personality in the classroom. How to introduce a personality? Person's name, time, period, and place. Personal background, then personality traits, significance, obstacles, important quote. So here, teacher can use it for introducing a writer in the classroom. History teacher can use it for introducing rulers in the classroom or leaders in the classroom. Science teachers to introduce scientists in the classroom. This bio cube creator activity can be used effectively in the classroom. Next is concept map. A concept map is a visual organization and representation of knowledge. It shows concepts and ideas and the relationships among them. So to organize ideas while reading a story or novel or an article, we use this concept map. During the guided practice section of a lesson, so the students can synthesize information just covered. As a closing activity also, we can use this concept map. Before a unit to access prior knowledge, we can use this concept map. As an assessment tool, we can use this concept map. This is a concept map I have taken, parts of plant. This is very familiar to all the teachers, but there is a difference between concept map and mind map. Mind map is something, personalized one is mind map. Concept map, we are writing only an organized way concepts. Next, PMI strategy. Plus, minus, interesting strategy. A PMI strategy can help you to brainstorm ideas, make decisions quickly by analyzing and weighing the pros and cons, identify strengths and weaknesses for future improvement. So it is used to encourage the examination of ideas, concepts, experiences from more than one perspective. PMI has developed by Dr. Edward De Bano, a proponent of critical and lateral thinking. This is PMI, plus advantages, benefits, strengths, positives, good things, minus disadvantages, deficiencies, weaknesses, then interesting strategy. So implications and possible outcome, attention grabbing, out of ordinary, these all will come under that. Can you stop annotate, please? This is an activity which I have taken from science. Leafy green vegetables are packed with vitamins and minerals. Eating a diet rich in leafy greens reduce risk of obesity, heart diseases, high blood pressure. This is plus points. Then minus, eating too much spinach can interfere with the ability of the body to absorb minerals, may lead to an excessive buildup of gas, bloating and cramps as our body needs some time to digest the excessive load of spinach. Then interesting, calcium in dark green leafy vegetables is more effectively absorbed by the body than that found in cow's milk. China is the largest producer of green leafy vegetables. So we are teaching this usually one by one we are teaching. But when we give such graphical organizers, students will understand a little more clearly. Next is thinking hat, six thinking hats. Okay. White, red, green, yellow, black, blue. So white for neutral, think about the facts and details of the topic, and red for emotions, examine a topic through emotions and feelings, and yellow for optimistic, think about the positive aspects of a topic, then green, critical, judgmental, think about negative aspects of a topic, black, then green, creative, use your imagination about the topic, then blue, observer, reflect, think metacognitive. So this is given like a branch form. Look at the red hat, fears, impact on others, feelings, intuition. White hat, information, figures, facts. Yellow hat, best scenario, benefits, positive thinking, optimism, like sunshine, you know. Then blue hat, process control, focus, big picture, agenda, summary, time management. Green hat, always creative thinking, okay, alternative solutions, develop an idea. Black hat, risk, potential problems, obstacles, downsides, weaknesses. So here goes, we can give the students, wear your thinking hats and do the activity. give different activities for the students, write the advantages, write the disadvantages, then create a story, create a report, some facts or information. So this activity can be given in the classroom. This is a very good activity. I have tried many times in my classroom this activity. This is also developed by Edward De Bano. This is used in multinational companies also to think in a, you know, to think focus, focus thinking for this. And this is jigsaw strategy. So when we hear about jigsaw, we think about puzzles. Puzzles always connect each other. So connections. So individual students are there in the class. We have to respect the individuality of the student. So those individual students, we are going to keep them in a home group. Look at that home group. Home group, there are four colors given: red, green, blue, yellow. Then next, expert group. Expert group, all green colors together. Expert groups are four here. So all colors together I kept here. So this is this can be established in very big classrooms, 40 students, 36 students. Some of